Hey, what's happening, y'all? This is George LaMond. Don't you go nowhere, because Profiles is coming right up.
Welcome to Profiles. I'm Marley Hall. Today's guest is Latin singing sensation George LaMond, who is currently reveling in the success of his latest release, a cover of Journey's Don't Stop Believin'. Additionally, George LaMond continues to bridge the gap between the American pop market and the Latin market. He's got a loyal following in both. After a short break, we'll join our host Mickey Burns as he welcomes singer George LaMond to Profiles. Welcome back to Profiles. During his three-decade career, George LaMond has placed numerous songs on Billboard's Top 100. However, his latest hit, a cover of Journey's Don't Stop Believin', could evolve into his biggest hit yet. Journey's version of the song has become the most downloaded song in music history, and LaMond's version consistently receives critical acclaim. So let's join our host, Mickey Burns, on location from Ashford & Simpson Sugar Bar in the heart of New York City, as he welcomes the popular George LaMond to Profiles.
Singer George LaMond, welcome to our show Profiles.
Thank you very much. I'm glad to be here.
Yeah, it's a pleasure meeting you today.
Finally.
Yes, finally. It's finally. A pleasure. Now, you've been labeled as an American freestyle singer, dance pop singer, salsa singer.
I like that one.
And Latino artist.
Can you tell?
Now, as a singer, how would you describe your style?
You know what? I got into this business because the number one thing I love to do is overall music. It's what it's what brings me pleasure.
Sure.
I've always, every time someone asks me that question, I basically say in Spanish, I'm just like a big beef stew, carne guisada. I love everything and anything. I would consider myself an overall singer. I love music, and I don't really hold myself to just one direction.
Right.
It just so happens that the popularity ones were the freestyle ones and the
yes,
salsa songs.
Yes. Now, you grew up in New York, right here.
I was
in the Bronx.
Right, Bronx.
And Bronx. Around 170th Street.
Go Mets.
How'd you first get interested in music?
When I was in Catholic school, there was a Coca-Cola commercial, and it was a doo-wop commercial. I used to mimic commercials, and we used to do doo-wop in the bathroom.
Oh.
So, of course, I did lead.
Yes, yes.
And it was a great commercial. I still remember. I think it went something like, used to go, Coke has life and everybody wants a little life. Ooh, ooh, Coke has life wherever you go. Coca-Cola, it's on its way. Coke has life and everybody wants a little life. Then all of us would go, ooh.
Well, we're going to send this tape to Coke.
There you go.
We'll get some,
endorsement.
We'll get some residuals.
That was one of my
working.
Favorite commercials, you know. I had to do it. It was just part of my upbringing, and I grew up in the hip-hop.
Yeah. Who were some of your early influences?
Luther Vandross was definitely one of my influences. Peebo Bryson was another huge, huge sure. motivation factor.
Great singers.
And Menudo. I actually auditioned for Menudo.
Really?
You have to remember, back in the days, you know, I was brought up in an era where I didn't have anyone as a Latino to look up to. So a lot of the singers that I looked up were either white or black. And I loved rock. I loved R&B. So when Menudo came out, that was something that I could grasp and say, okay, well, I can do that. You know,
Latin group.
And I actually auditioned. I made, I remember it was in Newark, New Jersey, out of the 500 kids that were there, I was down to 50.
Yeah,
and I was down to 15, and I heard they gave it to Ricky Martin.
Oh, yeah. Both of you have had good careers.
Yeah, but yeah. A little bit better for Ricky.
Yeah, but you know, your longevity might be a little
stronger.
I can't
complain. I'm blessed.
Now, you started out in freestyle music. That was really your first exposure, correct?
That was a direction, yes.
That was a direction. For us who may not be familiar with it, how would you describe freestyle music?
Freestyle is like a fast tempo of hip hop music.
Oh, I didn't know that.
That's all it is. The majority of the tempos and the majority, they're all love ballads.
I didn't know that.
A faster tempo. Huh. So it's considered dance since the tempo is up, you know, and a lot of the singers used to freestyle it.
So it's basically up-tempo dance?
Dance music, that's
but,
all.
But from hip-hop?
From hip-hop,
those
exactly. That's where it derived through, those are roots. That's where it fused in from.
Very good.
And then it turned into a lot of other stuff.
Now, you've had several huge hits.
I have some good songs. Yeah.
Currently, you might be sitting on your biggest hit. Mm-hmm. When you recently decided to release a cover of Journey's Don't Stop Believin.
Great song.
How'd that come about?
I was away from the English scene for a while because I started doing the salsa thing.
Right.
I did very well with that, thanks to Mark Anthony.
Yes.
And I wound up doing backgrounds for a friend of mine. His name is Lucas Prada.
Yeah.
And the producer, who I've heard had a lot of well-known hits, said, I have a song you might want to do.
Yeah.
So when he told me Journey, I mean, who wants to touch a Steve Perry song?
Well, that was my next question.
Yeah, you know, yeah. And the first thing I said is like, you know, I'm not sure, number one, I don't want to ruin a classic. You know, you have your diehard rock fans that leave it alone, you know? And I told them, if we're going to do this, let's just keep it exactly like the record, dude. And if it's not going to work, I don't even want to release it.
Wow.
So I wound up recording a song, and I left that day. They were ecstatic. I was just bummed. I thought I did a crappy job. I'm the hardest critic on my...
Sure.
And I really, really thought it was a bad job. I got the mix the next day. He emailed it to me, you know, because we're in the future now.
And you said, I didn't do that.
I couldn't believe what he did. And it came out great, and I was just happy emotionally, and I couldn't believe that I did that.
And I guess one of the reasons that no one before you has successfully covered that tune is that you really need an extraordinary voice to pull it off.
You need a range, yes.
You need a range. Yeah, I mean, Steve Perry.
Yeah.
So you knew that it wasn't going to be easy coming in.
I actually, and no one knows this, I almost, at one time when I was doing the song, Giuseppe was like, why don't you take a break?
Right.
Because we were going to go into To the Night. And I was belting it out. That's my head voice. That's not my diaphragm.
Yeah, yeah.
And I almost fainted.
You're pushing it.
I pushed it only because you need to get it right. It was a couple of takes.
And you needed to get
somewhere
you might not have been before.
Exactly. And he goes, I know you can do it. It's in there.
Yeah,
and I remember I did it. I closed my eyes. And all I remember was I felt a little faint and I almost stepped back.
Wow.
Yeah, and it's incredible what the body can
do
sometimes. But I got it. I nailed
it.
Yeah,
you know?
And I'm
great.
Like, make sure you don't delete that sucker, boy. Save it.
Well, I hope you got that.
Yeah,
right?
He got it.